Welcome to TMC Virtual Classroom. Myself, Dayashankar Vishwakarma. Now today I am going to start with one of the interesting topic in geometry, that is trigonometry. Now before going to start with the trigonometry, first I would like to tell you some basic thing about the trigonometry so that the thing should be clear. So let's start with the trigonometry. Now here the word trigonometry. There are two words. Tri means three. Metro means figure. Your trigonometry is a topic which is related to one of the figure which is called as triangle. Now here if I talk about trigonometry, if I will give you a definition of trigonometry. Now here trigonometry is, it is a branch of maths which deals with a right angled triangle. Trigonometry, it is a branch of mathematics which deals with a right angled triangle. It means it is specially related to right angled triangle. Now here in trigonometry we will study six types of ratios. In trigonometry we will study six types of ratio, that is sine, cos, tan, cot, sec and cosec. Here in trigonometry we are going to study this six types of ratio: sine, cos, tan, cot, sec, cosec. Now before going to start with this six types of ratio, first we will try to understand some basic thing about right angle triangle. Now here I will draw a triangle. This is A, B, C. This is the right angle triangle A, B, C. In this triangle, this side is called as hypotenuse. Now here, this is what? Height. And this one is base. In trigonometry, this is related to right angle triangle. In right angle triangle we have hypotenuse, height and base, and related to this we have one formula that is called as Pythagoras theorem. What is Pythagoras theorem? Pythagoras theorem is hypotenuse square is equal to height square plus base square. Hypotenuse square is equal to height square plus base square. This is the formula to find out the sides of the right angle triangle. If the two sides are given, we can find out the third one with the help of this formula. If these two sides are given, we can find out the base with the help of this formula. So this is one of the most important formula in the Pythagoras theorem and which is related to our trigonometry. Now here I am not going to rub the formula, I will keep as it is. Let us see, I will draw one more triangle here which is a right angle triangle. So this is P, Q and R, and here I have marked this angle. Now I just told trigonometry is related to right angle triangle. So in right angle triangle Now, if I talk about the six ratio, now see, first one is a sine, second one is a cos, third one is a tan. Now here, the fourth one is cot, fifth one is sec, and the sixth one is cosec. Now here, these are the six ratio which is related to the this right angle triangle. So what we are going to do, how we can study? Now see, if I mark here one angle theta, suppose this angle is theta. Now here the sine means, there is a meaning of sine. Sine means what? Opposite side upon hypotenuse. What about cos? Cos theta means what? If I talk about cos theta means what? Adjacent side upon hypotenuse. If I talk about tan theta is opposite side upon adjacent side. Okay. We will talk this one. Okay, let us complete this three. Okay. Now here in sine theta. Now see, sine theta is what? The meaning of sine theta is this: opposite side upon hypotenuse. Let us see the figure. Now here we have theta. Here is the theta. Opposite side means what? Opposite of this. Just iske samne dekhna. We have to see the front of this. This is called as opposite side. Now, hypotenuse, we all know that this is always hypotenuse. This is never going to be changed. This is always hypotenuse. So here, sine means what? Opposite side upon hypotenuse. If I talk, if we'll see the figure. Here in the figure, opposite side is what? PQ. Here I will write down PQ upon. Hypotenuse is what? PR. Now here, this is completed. Similarly, if we'll talk about the cos theta, then cos theta is adjacent side upon hypotenuse. Now remember one thing. As I told, this is opposite side. This one is hypotenuse. So remaining one is always adjacent side. This one is always adjacent side. So here in the figure, what we will do? We will write down QR. Now see, adjacent side is QR upon PR. Now here tan theta, in the tan theta, we will take this opposite side and adjacent side. Opposite and adjacent. It means PQ upon QR. It means here we are taking opposite side and adjacent side. So what I will write down here? PQ upon QR. This is the formula for the sine, cos and tan. I'll tell you one basic thing. Now see, remember one thing. Sine is opposite of cosec. Cos is opposite of sec. And tan is opposite of cot. These are the opposite of each other. Once you are knowing of this three, you can easily find out this three. So that's why, now see, I know that this three, I have just find out this three. So now I can find out this three. So how I can find out? Now pay attention. Cot theta, sec theta and cosec theta. Let us see the cot theta. Cot theta is opposite of tan theta. Cot theta and tan theta both are opposite of each other. What is tan theta? Tan theta is opposite side upon adjacent side, that is PQ upon QR. So let us take the converse. Opposite means what? Converse. So here opposite side upon adjacent side will become, adjacent will go as a numerator and this will become as a denominator. So adjacent side upon opposite side. So what I'm going to write down here? Adjacent side upon opposite side. That is equal to QR upon PQ. QR upon PQ. Here we have completed the cot theta. Now we will see the cos theta. Cos theta and sec theta both are opposite of each other. So what I am going to write down, this formula will become here hypotenuse upon adjacent side. And that is equal to PR will go up, that is PR will become numerator and this will become as a denominator. So we will write down PR upon QR. Now the last one is cosec theta, and cosec theta is the opposite of sine theta. These two are opposite of each other. So here sine theta is opposite upon hypotenuse. It means here I will write down hypotenuse upon opposite side, that is equal to PR upon PQ. PR upon PQ. Here we have completed six formulas. These are the six formulas which is very, very, very important for your upcoming exercise. So please student, copy this one. Now let's continue with the next formula. Today in this class, I will just explain you all the formulae so that in the next lecture, we will try to complete our exercise. So here I have completed the six formulae. So let us start with the next few formulae. Okay. Now, just now I told sine and cosec. Sine theta is opposite of cosec theta. These are the opposite. Cos theta is opposite of sec theta. And tan theta is opposite of cot theta. These are the opposite of each other. This will help you in all the formulae. Once you are knowing this one, this is very, 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 very important for us. So once you are knowing this three, you can easily find out this three. Okay. Now the next formula is, if I talk about sine theta, so sine theta is always converse of, or you can say the reciprocal of cosec theta. Sine and cosec both are opposites. So sine theta is always equal to 1 upon cosec theta. Second one is cos theta is equal to 1 upon sec theta. Third one is tan theta is equal to 1 upon cot theta. Fourth one is cot theta is equal to 1 upon tan theta. Fifth one is sec theta is equal to 1 upon sec is opposite of what? Cos. So sec theta is 1 upon cos theta. And the last one is, here I am going to write down the last one, that is cosec theta is equal to 1 upon sin theta. Because cosec is opposite of sine. Cosec is opposite of sine and sec is opposite of cos. Cot is opposite of sec. That's why, now see, sine ka cosec, cosec ka sine. Cos will become 1 upon sec and sec will become 1 upon cos. Tan will become 1 upon cot and cot will become 1 upon tan. Now, here for tan and cot, we have one more formula. For tan and cot, we have one more formula. That is, and this is very ampy, tan theta is equal to sin theta upon cos theta. This is one of the most important formula. Okay, now here about cot theta, now see, tan ka is what? Sin upon cos. So cot theta will become cos theta upon sin theta. Here we have done 8 formulae. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 formula. These are the very, very, very important formulae. Now, we will try to buy some more important ones. Some identities, or either important, or we can say that important formula. Okay, some most important identities which is very important for our 10th standard. This was already given in the 9th standard as a basic, but now here in 10th standard we are going to study this one as a most important formula, and this identities will help you in the exercise 6.1. Whenever we are going to start the prove that question, these are the very, very important formula. Now, this is the first formula. first formula is sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. This is one of the most important formula. Sine square theta plus cos square theta is always equal to 1. ये अपने को बाहर रखना है. This is the very very important formula. On the basis of this formula, I can prove two more formula. Now see, the second formula is second formula. Now see, I will start from here. Sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1 होता है. Now if I divide this whole equation by sine square, now see, if I am dividing by sine square upon here sine square, and this is equal to sine square. So what happened here? This will get cancelled. So here finally this is going to be 1 plus cos upon sine. Now see here. Cos upon sine is what? Cos upon sine is cot. So here cos upon sine is will become cot square theta, and 1 upon sine. 1 upon sine will give you 1 upon sine will give you cosec square theta. So here 1 upon sine will give you cosec square theta. This is one of the most important formula, second formula. And this was one formula. I have derived this one from the first formula. Now once again I will derive one more formula from the first. Third formula is sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. This is the first formula. On the basis of this first formula, I will derive one more formula. That is, now see, here in this case, I have divided the whole equation by sine square. Now here, in this case, I will divide the whole equation by cos square. Let's see. Sine square theta divided by cos square theta plus cos square theta divided by, cos square theta divided by cos square theta, that is equal to 1. Now what happened here? This 2 will get cancelled. 1s are, and finally what I will write, here I have to also divide cos square theta. Now see, sine upon cos is what? Sine upon cos is tan theta. Sine upon cos is what? Tan theta. This is tan theta. So here instead of this, I will write down tan square theta plus, this is going to be 1, that is equal to 1 upon cos, where is 1? Yeah. 1 upon cos is nothing but sec. 1 upon cos is nothing but sec. So instead of 1 upon cos, I will write down sec. So here I am going to write down sec square theta. And finally, this is also one of the identity. It means we have three identity, this one, and this one. Now, on the basis of this identity, we can conclude that, now pay attention here. Now, what was the first one? First one is sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Agar main isko idhar transfer karu, so what happened here? Therefore, sine square theta will become, now here this is plus, this will go here and will become minus. So here 1 minus cos square theta. This is a one more formula but related to this one only. Suppose if I am transferring this one this side, so what happened here? I will left with cos square theta, and that is equal to 1 minus sine square theta. Okay, so whenever I am going to ask the formula, you people are going to answer these three together. It means how you are going to answer? Now see, I am repeating. Sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Then just keep this one here only. Sine square theta is equal to 1 minus cos square theta. And next one is transfer this one to that side. Cos square theta is equal to 1 minus sine square theta. Now the second formula is, second one was this one. 1 plus cot square theta is equal to cosec square theta. Now what I will do? I will transfer this one to this side. So what happened here? I will left with cot square theta is equal to cosec square theta minus 1. Or I can transfer this one to that side. So what happened here? I will left with 1. 1 is equal to cosec square theta minus cot square theta. These are the group of next three formulae. And the last one is tan square theta plus 1 is equal to sec square theta. Now see, this was the third formula. What I will do? I will transfer 1 to this side. So what happened here? Tan square theta is equal to sec square theta minus 1. Then in the next case, what I will keep 1 here only. I will transfer this one to this side. So what happened here? So 1 is equal to sec square theta minus tan square theta. Now this is the group of next three formula. Now here I have completed the most important identities, which is very, very, very important for our trigonometry exercise 6.1, which is related to prove that question. These are going to be used in the prove that formula. Okay. Now here, after the completion of this, now I will tell you how to bihead the table. In trigonometry, there is a table, which is also very important to find out the values. Okay. Now let me rub this one first. Now we will try to learn how to bihead the table. Now in trigonometry, table is one of the most important thing to find out value. Okay, now before, so your trigonometric table, here I am going to start with the trigonometric table. Okay. First one is sine theta, then here cos theta, then here tan theta, cot theta, sec theta, and cosec theta. Okay, student, remember one thing, these are the fixed sequence. Whenever you are bihating either formula or table, you have to bihead in this pattern only, because in the textbook maybe that these things are given as randomly, but here you have to bihead as it is. Whenever you are going to learn trigonometry, these are the sequence. You have to bihead in this pattern only. Now see. Now the first, let me write down the values. Here it is 0 degree. Then 30 degree, then 45 degree, then 60 degree, and here is the last one, that is 90. 0, 30, 45, 60, 90. This we have in our syllabus, so we have to bihead this one. And I have completed the table. Now inside the table, now we will try to write down the values. Values are very important. Okay, now pay attention. So I will give you one trick. With the help of that trick, you are not supposed to bihead. You have to learn how to draw this table. Because in exams, sometimes what happens, you are having so many chapters, but you are not able to remember everything at a time. So once you are knowing the trick, you can easily understand how to bihead, how to draw the table. Now see, whenever we are going to draw the table, you all are knowing the number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, these are the five numbers, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. अभी करना क्या है, यू हैव टू डिवाइड ईच एंड एवरी नंबर बाय 4. यू हैव टू डिवाइड ईच एंड एवरी नंबर बाय 4. आफ्टर डिवाइडिंग ईच एंड एवरी नंबर बाय 4, यू हैव टू टेक द स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ ईच एंड एवरी नंबर. यू हैव टू टेक द स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ ईच एंड एवरी नंबर. सो व्हाट हैपेंड हियर, 0 अपॉन एनीथिंग इज ऑलवेज 0. 0 अपॉन एनीथिंग इज ऑलवेज 0. सो हियर दिस इज गोइंग टू बी 0. And if you are taking the root of 0, it is always 0. So 0 upon anything is always 0 and root of that number is always 0. 1 upon 4. Now see, root 1 upon 4. Here 1 ka root is 1 and 2 ka root is 4 ka root is 2. Okay, that's why here we will write down 1 upon 2. Now here I will cancel this. 2 1s are 2 2s are. Now here after cancelling, this will become 1 upon 2. So inside the 1 upon 2, that can be written as, once I will take this one outside the root, this will become 1, but this can't come outside the root, that's why this will remain inside the root. Now here this is 1 upon root 2. So the next one is 1 upon root 2. Now here, 3 will remain inside the root and 4 will come outside the root and it will become 2. The square root of 4 is 2 and here 4 1s are 4 1s are. 1 upon 1 means 1 only. And 1 ka root is 1. These are the number which I am going to place over here. So what happened now, see, this 0 I will place here. 1 upon 2 I will place here. 1 upon root 2 I will place here. Root 3 upon 2 I will place here. And 1, that is going to be here. Now these are the number which is very 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 important. I'll tell you the same thing once again, but let me complete the table. Now see, sine 0, here instead of theta, if I put 0 degree, what sine 0 is 0. But here if I am putting 30 degree, the sine 30 is 1 upon 2. If I am putting here 45 degree, the sine 45 is 1 upon root 2. And sine 60 is root 3 upon 2 and sine 90 is 1. ये अपने को अच्छी तरह से बाय हेड करके लेना. दिस वी हैव टू बाय हेड एज इट इज. ओके, आफ्टर द कंप्लीशन ऑफ साइन व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, यू हैव टू जस्ट रिवर्स द नंबर. मतलब ये नंबर को जस्ट रिवर्स कर देना यहां से शुरू करने का. तो कैसे करेंगे, इसको मैं रफ कर दे रहा हूं, जस्ट अ मिनट. हाँ, दिस वन विल कम हियर, दिस नंबर विल कम हियर रूट 3 अपॉन 2. This is 1 upon root 2 and this one is 1 upon 2 and this will go here 0. Now your sine and cos both are completed. Sine and cos both are completed. Now we have to find out tan, cot, sec, cosec. First, okay. Now remember one thing. Sine ka relation is with what? Cosec. These are the two opposite and this is related to this. Opposite means converse. Okay. So what I will do? Let me rub this one. Okay, sine ka opposite is cosec. Then let us try to find out cosec. Now see, pay attention here. As we know that sine theta is equal to 1 upon cosec theta. Or you can say cosec theta is equal to 1 upon sine theta. These are the two formula. I suppose to find out cosec theta. So that is equal to 1 upon sine theta. Sine theta. See, sir. अगर मैं 0 लेता हूं, इफ आई एम टेकिंग 0, तो 0 का वैल्यू इज साइन 0 इज 0. सो हियर आई एम गोइंग टू राइट डाउन 0 एंड 1 अपॉन 0 इज इक्वल टू दिस साइन इज कॉल्ड एज नॉट डिफाइंड. नॉट डिफाइंड दिस साइन 1 अपॉन 0 इज नॉट डिफाइंड, बट 0 अपॉन 1 इज ऑलवेज 0. पाई अपॉन 0 इज नॉट डिफाइंड. Whenever we are having 0 as a denominator, whenever we are having 0 as a denominator, that is not defined. It means in the mathematics, there is a no number like this. So here I am going to rub this one. So what I will do here? Here the sine 0 is 0, but cos 0 is going to be not defined. End is not defined. Now see, sine 30 is 1 upon 2. Sine 30 is equal to 1 upon 2. Then cosec 30 will give you 2 upon 1. तो ये ऊपर जाएगा और ये नीचे से प्लस 2 अपॉन 1 दैट इज इक्वल टू 2 ओनली दैट इज इक्वल टू 2 ओनली सो व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू राइट डाउन हियर दिस इज गोइंग टू बी 2 सो साइन कोसेक 30 इज 2 नाउ लेट अस सी कोसेक 45 सो साइन 45 इज 1 अपॉन रूट 2 कोसेक 45 इज गोइंग टू बी इट विल गो अप एंड विल कम डाउन दैट इज रूट 2 अपॉन 1 रूट 2 अपॉन 1 मींस व्हाट रूट 2 ओनली And here this is sine 60 is 3 upon root 3 upon 2. So once again we will take the reciprocal of this. It will become 2 upon root 3. And finally 1. 1 now see sine 90 is equal to 1. Now we have to find out cosec 90. Now we all know 1 upon 1 means 1. Agar main isko upar niche karu bhi. तो भी क्या आएगा 1 अपॉन 1 आएगा एंड फाइनली 1 ही आएगा तो 1 का क्या होने वाला है यहां पे 1 ही आने वाला है यस सो वी हैव कंप्लीटेड दिस वन फॉर द साइन का अपोजिट कोसेक से नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट कोसेक का अपोजिट इज सेक हियर वी हैव 1 सो आई कैन राइट डाउन 1 हियर दिस इज 3 root 3 upon 2 दिस विल बिकम 2 upon root 3 उल्टा हो जाएगा हियर दिस इज 1 upon root 2 सो व्हाट हैपेंड दिस इज root 2 root 2 ऊपर जाएगा 1 नीचे आएगा तो 1 लिखने का जरूरत नहीं है This is 1 upon 2. So we will write down 2 and 0 aega. So 0 is not defined. Aisa karo ya phir isko kya karo reverse kar do. Ye pura idhar turn kar do. Is taraf aa jaye. Aisa karenge to bhi kya hoga ye apna easily ho jayega. To main yahan pe turn kar de raha hu. Now pay attention here. So 1 will come here. This is going to be 2 upon root 3. This root 2 as it is. This 2 as it is. And ND, ND means not defined. जैसे मैंने अभी बताया zero रहेगा तो ND not defined. One का one ही आएगा. Three upon root three upon two था. देखो two upon root three हो गया. One upon root two था. यहाँ पर root two हो गया. One upon two था. Now here it will become two. Now here we have completed the sine, cos, sec and cosec. Now we have to find out tan and cot. Let us try to find out tan and cot. How we can find out tan and cot? As I have given a formula, since tan ka formula mein tan theta is equal to what? Sin theta upon cos theta. This formula I have given. Sin theta is equal to tan theta is equal to sin theta upon cos theta. Now here sin theta, see that sin 0. Apne ko suppose yahan pe tan 0 फाइंड आउट करना है तो यहां पे sin 0 अपॉन cos 0 0 दैट इज इक्वल टू sin 0 इज व्हाट 0 एंड cos 0 इज व्हाट 1 0 अपॉन 1 तो 0 अपॉन 1 इज ऑलवेज 0 ये मैंने एक फाइंड आउट कर दिया सिमिलरली नाउ सी देयर सिमिलरली tan 30 अगर मुझे फाइंड आउट करना tan 30 इज इक्वल टू व्हाट sin 30 upon cos 30. Sin 30 is how much? Sin 30 is 1 upon 2 upon cos 30 is how much? Cos 30 is root 3 upon 2. अब इसको कैसे सॉल्व करेंगे? Now 1 upon 2 I will write down here. Now this is the upon sin. This will convert into division. Upon means the division. And divide by what? Root 3 upon 2. That is equal to 1 upon 2. Abhi division sign will change into multiplication. Division sign will change into multiplication. And finally this will become 2 upon root 3. So what happened here? 2 and 2 will get cancelled. We will left with 1 ones are 1. And root 3 ones are root 3. So here tan 30 is 1 upon root 3. So let me write down this in the table. So now here, tan 0 is 0, tan 30 is 1 upon root 3. Now let us find out tan 45. Tan 45 is equal to sin 45 upon cos 45. Sin 45 is 1 upon root 2. Cos 45 is 1 upon root 2. Let me write this one. Here 1 upon root 2 upon 1 upon root 2. That is equal to 1 upon root 2. मैं इसको डायरेक्टली डिवीजन को मल्टीप्लिकेशन में कन्वर्ट कर रहा हूँ। देखो मैं डिवीजन बोला था, डिवीजन को बाद में मल्टीप्लिकेशन में कन्वर्ट करते। वैसे यहाँ पे डायरेक्टली डिवीजन को मैंने मल्टीप्लिकेशन में कन्वर्ट किया। नाउ दिस विल बिकम रेसिप्रोकल। रेसिप्रोकल मतलब रूट टू ऊपर गया, वन नीचे आ गया। नाउ से रूट टू वन जा, रूट टू वन जा कैंसिल होगा एंड हियर दिस इज गोइंग टू बी वन। हियर आई गॉट द वैल्यू ऑफ टेन फोर्टी फाइव। तो टेन फोर्टी फाइव इज इक्वल टू वन। नाउ लेट अस फाइंड आउट कॉस 60 tan 60 and tan 90. Tan 60. Let us try to find out tan 60. Let me rub this one. Yes, friend. Now let us see the tan 60. Tan 60 is equal to sin 60 upon cos 60. That is equal to sin 60 is how much? Sin 60 is here. Root 3 upon 2. That is about. Cos 60 is how much? Cos 60 is this one. 1 upon 2. That is equal to root 3 upon 2 multiplied by. Now this will become reciprocal. 2 upon 1. Now here I will cancel. 2 1s are 2 1s are. Here this is going to be root 3. This is only root 3. So what happened here? Tan 60 is root 3. And let us find out tan 90 also. Huh? Tan 90 is equal to sin 90 upon cos 90. Sin 90 is 1, cos 90 is 0. So 1 upon 0. Here I will write down 1. This is upon 0. And anything upon 0, anything upon 0 is always not defined. Anything upon 0 is always not defined. So what I am going to write down here? Here I will write down, see this one, root 3. And here this is going to be not defined. Now here we have completed tan. After the completion of tan, so what we will do? We will just reverse this one. Isko reverse kar dene ka, because they are opposite of each other. Reverse kar de, to bhi chalega, ya iska converse lete jaun. तो अगर मैं इसको यहां पर ट्रांसफर करूं तो व्हाट हैपेंस, दिस इज एन डी, दिस इज रूट थ्री, दिस वन विल कम हियर ओनली एंड दिस विल गो हियर, वन अपॉन रूट थ्री एंड हियर दिस इज गोइंग टू बी जीरो। फाइनली दिस टेबल इज कंप्लीटेड। दिस टेबल इज कंप्लीटेड और हियर वी आर फिनिश विद द टेबल। सो स्टूडेंट, so before going to end with this lecture, I am going to just have a small revision for what I have taught in today's lecture. Now in today's lecture, first I told about, in today's lecture I told about the trigonometry. What is trigonometry? Trigonometry is a branch of mathematics which deals with right angle triangle. Then I have started with the right angle triangle. In right angle triangle I told all the six ratios, sine, cos, tan, cot, sec, cosec. Then from each and every ratio, I have given some formulas. And I have given three special identities. And that is sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Second one is 1 plus cot square theta is equal to cosec square theta. And the third one is 1 plus tan square theta is equal to sec square theta. All the three formulas are very, very, very important. So I request you all to learn this one. So in the next class, we'll have a mock test. Then I will continue with the next exercise. Thank you.